Good day to all. For this video lesson, we are going to convert English unit to another English unit and English unit to metric unit. Recall that in measurement, we have two kinds of system, the metric system and the English system. In the previous video, I showed you how to convert the units in the metric system. These units are internationally agreed system and commonly used in the world. For length, we have the base unit, meter. For mass, we have gram. Volume, liter. And for temperature, we have degree Celsius. Conversion of these units is easy because it is based on the powers of 10. And we can simply use this mnemonic device to better remember the order of the units from largest to smallest. For this video lesson, we're going to focus on the English system, wherein this is often used in United States and England, and these are the units we use for length. We have inch, foot, and mile. For mass, we have ounce, pound, and ton. For volume, pint, quart, and gallon. And for temperature, we have degree Fahrenheit. Conversion of units for this system is a bit complicated because it has various equivalent. Let us focus first on the length. Kapag nagko-convert tayo ng units, depende ito sa given. If we are converting foot, yard, inches, and mile to each other, that is English to English system, wherein 1 foot equals 12 inches, 1 yard equals 3 feet, and since we have 3 feet in a yard, 3 times 12, that is 36, 1 yard means 36 inches. And also, 1 mile equals 5,280 feet. And we also have this kind of conversion. If we have inches, feet, yard, miles to the metric units just like centimeters and meters, ayun naman ang tinatawag na English to metric system, wherein 1 inch equals 2.54 centimeters, 1 foot equals 0.3048 meter, 1 yard equals 0.9144 meter, and 1 mile equals 1,609.344 meters. So let's have some examples. Let's convert English unit to another English unit. And let's be guided with this conversion table. Number 1, 5 feet into inches. So dito, i-rewrite lang natin yung given at lagyan natin ng over 1 to make it as a fraction. I-multiply natin to another fraction using the following equivalents. So here, since we are converting foot into inches, let's use this conversion. Another guide is whenever we do conversions, it's important to put whatever we want to convert on top and whatever given we have on the bottom. So, ibig sabihin sa fraction na to, dahil gusto natin ng inches, ang inches unit ang ilalagay natin sa taas, and kung ano naman yung given, ay yun yung nasa bottom. So, the given here is feet. Using this, 1 foot equals 12 inches. Ilalagay lang natin yung value dito. 1 foot equals 12 inches. And then, imamultiply na natin. So, 5 times 12, that is 60. And 1 times 1 is 1. Kaya natin nilagay yung given sa ibaba is to easily cancel that. Para ang matira na lamang is yung kinonvert nating unit into inches. So, therefore, the answer here is 60 inches. Let's have number 2. 5 yards to feet. This time, tingnan natin kung meron tayong direct conversion with that. Yes, we do have. 1 yard equals 3 feet. So, katulad ng ginawa natin kanina, we simply copy the given over 1 and then we multiply it to a fraction na may conversion into feet from yards. Again, we copy the given sa bottom at ang gusto natin i-convert sa taas. Here, we have 3 feet in 1 yard. And then, we multiply. 5 times 3, 15 feet. And then, 1 times 1 is simply 1. Therefore, 5 yards equals 15 feet. Number 3, 23 miles, 2 yards. Notice na sa ating conversion table ay wala tayong direct conversion ng miles into yards. What we have here is into feet lang. Therefore, let's convert first miles into feet and then feet into yards. So we'll be using this and this one. So let's have the same given, 23 miles. Gawin muna natin to into feet. So that will give us 1 mile equal to 5,280 feet. So here, notice na pareha silang nasa taas, we simply multiply that. So we'll have 23 times 5,280, 121,440 feet. That is not yet the final answer. We still need to convert that into yards. Again, ilagay natin sa ilalim yung given and then yung i-convert natin into yards sa numerator. 1 yard equals 3 feet. So, we can cancel this one para yards na lang ang matira. Notice na nasa denominator ang 3. That means we're going to divide that. 121,440 times 1 is the same number divided by 3. That will give us 40,480 yards. And that will be our final answer. 23 miles equals 40,480 yards. Okay? Let's have English to metric system. This time, ito naman ang conversion table na gagamitin natin. And let's still follow the same conversion tip. Let's convert 16 inches to centimeters. So we're going to use this. And then, let's follow the same rule. We multiply the given over 1 to a fraction wherein ang numerator is ang unit na gagawin natin at ang denominator is yung given, which is inches. We have 1 inch equals 2.54 centimeters. So here, when we multiply, diretso lang, numerator times numerator, 16 times 2.54, 40.64 centimeters. 16 inches equals 40.64 centimeters. Next, number 2, 80 centimeters, 2 inches. Let's just copy the given and multiply it wherein we have the numerator equals sa unit na kailangan natin gawin at ang denominator which is the given. So, we can have 2.54 centimeters that is equal to 1 inch. So, that will be 80 times 180 divided by 2.54. So, that will give us 31.50 inches. That's equal to 80 centimeters. Okay, let's have number 3. 20 feet to meters. So, let's use this one. Again, let's just copy the given 20 feet, convert it into meters. So, 1 foot equals 0.3048 meters. 20 times 0.3048, that will give us 6.096, and that will be in meters. 20 feet equals 6.096 meters. Okay, so sa pag-convert ng length, tingnang mabuti kung ano yung dalawang units na kailangang i-convert. Is it from English to English or English to metric? Now, let's proceed sa area. Actually, we also have the same way. Remember, kapag area, this is in square units, wherein 1 square foot equals 144 square inches. Remember kanina, 1 feet equals 12 inches. At dahil square units na to, it means 12 times 12. Kaya naman naging 144 square inches. 1 square yard equals 9 square feet. 1 acre equals 43,560 square feet. And 1 mile equals 640 acres. Kapag ganyan ang mga units, that's English to English system. While, if we have inch, acre, and yard into centimeter, hectometer, and square meters, that will be from English to metric system. So let's have English to English first. Again, let's be guided with this conversion table and with this tip. We will follow the same process of conversion. 8 square feet into square inches. So dito, we have 1 square foot equals 144 square inches. Still, let's just copy the given and multiply it sa fraction wherein ang numerator is yung unit na gagawin natin while yung denominator is the given, which is square feet. So let's use 1 square foot equals 144 square inches. So it simply means 80 times 144, 11,520 square inches. So therefore, our final answer is this. Next, let's have 3,000 acres, 2 miles. We can use this one. And let's follow the same rule. We copy the given and multiply it wherein ito yung gusto nating unit at nasa baba ang given. So we have 1 square mile equals 640 acres. So here, 3,000 times 1 is 3,000 divided by 640. That will give us 4.6875 square miles. Okay? Alright, this time, let's convert English to metric units for area. And we'll be guided with this conversion table. Okay, number 1, 2,400 square centimeters into square inches. So here, we have this direct conversion. We simply copy the given and multiply it with the equivalent units. Again, ang nasa numerator is yung gusto nating ma-convert into, that's square inches, at yung nasa baba naman is yung given, which is square centimeters. Here, we are given 1 square inch equals 6.45 square centimeters. So we simply multiply 2,400 times 1 divided by 6.45. That will give us 372.09 square inches. Therefore, 2,400 square centimeters is equal to this. Next, 3.5 square kilometers into square yards. As you notice, wala tayong direct conversion from kilometers into yards. Ang meron lang tayo ay square meters. So here, what we can do is to convert first 3.5 square kilometers into square meters para magamit natin itong conversion na ito. Remember, if we are converting metric to metric system, we can use the mnemonic device King Henry died by drinking chocolate milk, wherein B is the base unit, which is meters, and K is for kilometers. And then, we are simply moving the decimal point. So, from kilometers, 1, 2, 3 into meters, that is 3 spaces. But remember that we are converting area units, wherein the exponent must be 2. Therefore, itong 3 na to ay kailangan pang i-multiply by 2. So, 3 times 2, 6. So, we're going to move it 6 spaces to the right. So, 3.5 kilometers, move it 6 spaces to the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then, let's fill this with zeros. We're going to have 3,500,000 square meters. That's equivalent to this. Let's convert this 3.5 square kilometers or 3,500,000 square meters into square yards using this conversion. 3,500,000 square meters, change it into square yards. So 1 square yard equals 0.836 square meters. So still, we can cancel this and multiply 3 million by 1, then divide it by 0.836. That will give us 4,186,602.87 yards. So this is our final answer. Basically, we will follow the same steps in converting mass units. So dito makikita nyo, pinagsalo ko lang sa isang slide yung units ng English to English system wherein we have pounds, ounces, tons, while English to metric system, we have the ounce, pounds, tons into grams or kilograms. So let's have the following examples. Number 1, we have 34 tons. The symbol for tons is letter T into pounds. The symbol for that is LB or LBS. We simply rewrite the given over 1 and multiply it sa fraction. So, ganun pa rin. Gusto natin to into pounds given now we have 34 tons. So, in this conversion table, we can use this. 1 ton equals 2,000 pounds. So we just need to substitute it here and do the operation. 34 times 2,000, that is 68,000. And then we can cancel this. Therefore, the final answer is 68,000 pounds. Next, number 2, 130 grams to ounces. We can use this, that is English to metric system. Copy the given 130 grams and multiply it sa fraction wherein ang numerator ay ounce, ang denominator ay grams. This time, 1 ounce equals 28.35 grams. So we can have 130 times 1, 130, divided by 28.35, 4.59 ounce. So this is the final answer for number 2. Next, number 3. Let's have 100 pounds into grams. So here, tingnan natin, alin dito yung pounds to grams. So here, as you can see, wala tayong direct conversion ng pounds and grams. What we have here is into kilograms. But remember, we can convert first kilograms into grams. Since we're talking about mass, the base unit for mass is the grams, and nandito ang ating given na kilograms. So we just need to move the decimal point 3 units to the right. From the given 1 pound equals 0.4536 kilograms into grams, let's just move it 3 decimal places. 1, 2, 3. So this will be equal to 453.6 grams. So we can say that 1 pound equals 453.6 grams. And then we can now easily convert the given 100 pounds, convert it into grams. So we need to have grams and the pounds here and then multiply. So we can cancel this and multiply 453.6 times 100. So that will give us 45,360. Okay? And the last one is about the volume. Again, pag sinabing volume, ito yung amount of space in a 3D figure. Kaya naman, if you will notice, ang ating mga units ay naka-cubic units. So, here are the units for English system, we have cubic foot, yards, cord, tablespoon, ounce, cup, pint, quart, and gallon. While English to metric system, we can have those units into milliliters, liters, or cubic meters. So let's have example for volume conversion. Again, we are guided with this conversion table and we will still follow the same steps. So the first one, 290 quarts into gallons. That is English to English system, and we can have this conversion. So let's compute. We simply copy the given and multiply it into fraction, wherein ang nasa taas is yung gusto natin gawing unit at ang nasang baba is yung given unit or kapareho nito. So here we have 1 gallon equal to 4 quarts. So 290 times 1 divided by 4, that is 72.5 gallons. So that is our answer for number 1. Number 2, 100 gallons to liters. So this time, we know that liters is in the metric system. Tingnan natin alin dito sa tatlong to ang gagamitin natin. Since we have gallon, we'll be using this. So let's compute. Copy the given and multiply it, wherein nasa taas yung gusto natin, that is liters, at nasa baba yung given. Here, we have 1 gallon equal to 3.7853 liters. 100 times 3.7853, that will give us 113.559 liters. Number 3, 8 gallons to pints. Gallons and pints are both English units. However, dito, wala tayong makikita ang direct conversion yan. So, what we have here is 1 gallon equals 4 quarts and 1 quart equals 2 pints. So, pwede nating i-convert muna into quarts before i-convert into pints. So, gallon, quarts, 2 pints. Let's have the main given, 8 gallons. Gawin muna natin siyang quarts. We have 4 quarts into 1 gallon. So 8 times 4, that's 32. Then we can cancel this para alam natin that this one is really quarts. Now we have 32 quarts, but we need to convert it still into pints. So 1 quart equal to 2 pints. So 32 times 2, that is 64. So therefore, 8 gallons equals 64 pints. Okay? Remember, we just followed the same steps from length, area, mass, and volume. We simply just multiply the given to a fraction wherein ang numerator is yung unit na i-convert natin while yung denominator is the given. So kung wala dyang direct conversion, you need to look first kung alin yung mga makakatutulong na units para makarating tayo sa final unit na gusto nating ma-achieve. So again, what we had in this video lesson is to convert English unit to another English unit, and we also showed examples of conversion from English to metric system. The next video lesson, applications of conversion through problem solving. So please make sure to watch the next video.